Well, hello there, geeks and hoes. You know I knows it's time for Shazbot to run the weekly review. I'm Jay that lame penis trick Jesse, and now this show is mine. I'm feeling fine like cherry wine.
Shazbot, what are you doing?
I'm shutting down.
I guess that brings us to what did we learn this week? Number one. This week we learned that 4.0.6 introduces another way for me to spend honor points I don't have. Apparently, now you can spend honor and justice points on vendor stuff. It's all trade skill junk like savage leather and elementium ore. It must say a lot about me that when I hear this, the only thing I think about is what it'll do to the auction house. I think it says a lot about me as a player that I'm so negative all the time. Numero dos. Ghostcrawler just cannot win. While the learn to play versus the go grind in an Asian MMO teams are fighting over if WoW is too hard or not, Ghostcrawler comes in and tries to, like, be a uniter and tells everyone to be civil and stop it. And now, while I enjoy seeing him struggle in vain to try and get people to stop this fight, it ain't ever gonna happen. And now he's just in the middle of it, and, I say, you know what, Ghostcrawler? Let them eat each other alive. Just stay out of it, dude. Let them bitch and complain. That's what they're gonna do anyway. If you make it easier, the hardcore people are gonna complain. If you make it harder, the casual people are gonna complain. You will never win. Give up. It's like fighting with a troll. Just ban them all. Number three. Saying does not equal doing. Turns out the devs have stated on numerous occasions that they think there's a possibility for maybe thinking about possibly doing in the future at some point if they decide that maybe they want to, nerfing pallies. And of course, our friends in pink decide to lose their freaking minds over it and just bitch up a storm. Now, you never hear me complaining about stuff that I have no control over that doesn't really exist or whatever. I mean, you guys need to appreciate what you have a bit more. Me, on the other hand, I will take my 10% buff to chain heal. Yeah! You guys are so getting nerfed. And finally, number four. Tolbarad is like this girl I knew in high school. She dressed like a whore, but swore she was a virgin. I never believed her, and I was pissed when I asked her to homecoming and nothing happened. I actually thought she was just telling me all that stuff, just to, like, seem like a good girl. Turned out she really was a virgin, and she only dressed like that because she was white trash. I don't know what this has to do with Tolbarad, but unlike her, that place really blows. The part of the show where we take a look at the past week and decide what rocked, what sucked. Epic! I ironically submit this as an epic of the week due to the hilarious nature of it. My guild leader was in a Pug 5 man, and he was in Grim Batal, which, for those puggers out there, you know sucks. And his group healer left because, well, he sucked. So I was asked to join, and I was like, sure, whatever, this will be easy. You know, me and you in there, we'll make this thing work. So several wipes later, we are like, okay, what the hell? We look at the DPS meters and charts and whatnot, and we see one of the guys is doing, like, 1/4 of what the tank is doing. And so basically my guild leader makes fun of him enough so that he leaves. And we bring in a DPS of our own. You think that would have solved the problem, but nope. Two more wipes later, we have to bring in a second DPS of our own. And then we wipe again. It's around this time that our pain and suffering turned into laughter and hilarity, as we couldn't even believe how bad this experience was. It was like watching the movie The Room.
It's over!
It's not over. Everybody betrayed me. I fed up with this world.
Flying bears are freaking awesome. Yes, they are. Better for you in any flying car. Cause they fly like the baby bears. The baby bears that fly in the air. I'm booted to be.
I don't even know what you just watched there. I love this scene. Note to Blizzard. A tad bit more of the lore never hurt anyone. Except for all those people who complain when you do it, or make internet memes about the lore you do use, or all those other times they make fun of your stuff, but you know what? Keep it up. I like it. And you know what we say to the people that complain?
Well, screw you! Trash!
Son of a bitch. How am I supposed to film and post a boss kill when I'm the first moron to get killed in phase 3? What would it look like if I had posted this video? I don't even want people thinking that I suck at this game. Wait. Oh crap. This is a dream. Hey, can someone explain to me the reasoning or lore behind the fact that two very dead and decapitated dragons are now both undead and bosses? Did the whole undead Lich King, now he's gone, there's another guy in his place, but there'll be no more undead thing stop? I'm pretty sure Sylvanas didn't have anything to do with it, and unless they're missing their faces now, I really doubt it's an old god thing. And just like that, it's time
for viewer responses!
Morgoth1990 asks, Dear Jesse, I have to know, do you play console games or are you just a PC gamer? I do, in fact, play console games, but I usually borrow them because I never really see the point in buying them, yet here I am playing a game where you have to pay to play. That's kind of silly, but yeah, the last game I bought was Rock Band 2, whenever the hell that came out. Zaku Zero says, It's like a taco within a KFC within a mall. It's inside your head. Bah. Yes, love you, Jesse. Hey, if you're thinking the same thing I'm thinking, I'm gonna go try and find some butterfly poo. And finally, we come to our failure. You know what? No. This week we're not gonna do it. This week is a dedication. A dedication to the greatest player ever. Rageheart. Now, I know what you might be saying. What makes him so great? Well, the fact that you don't even know makes you a lesser player for not knowing his greatness. Let me tell you his tale, my friends. Bask in his glory. Long ago, like several days in fact, four young men joined together to run a five-man. Unfortunately, their guild was filled with lazy bastard tanks who refused to join them. Yes, you heard me, guild. So they were forced to pug. After waiting for what seemed like an eternity, when they were just about to give up, suddenly, like a white light from heaven, the great and powerful Rageheart appeared. He would DK tank it for us, and with it, steal my heart forever. His powerful attacks made all other DPS within his presence look like girls struggling to get away from me when I awkwardly pretend to trip on them, grabbing their boobs for support. His main tanking abilities were second to none. Even the M1A2 Abrams tank fitted with reactive armor was nothing compared to him. My friends, he played his part like a concert pianist. Flawlessly. But no! Suddenly, my guild leader said, I want in that dungeon! My guildies were prepared to boot this magnificent beast! Why? Why, I asked? Were they jealous of his power? I know not. But I lobbied against them. I demanded they not vote for this titan of the taunt! And at the last moment, the vote was tallied, and he stayed to finish up and get us the unneeded loot. Thank you, Rageheart. You have the brass balls of a giant and the wisdom of an old stereotyped Chinese man. I love you. And that's it for this week. Thumbs up, subscribe, all that garbage, etc., etc. And as always, to be continued.